In this video, we learn what is living, and the characteristics of living beings. What are the different characteristics of living beings and what is living? This is chapter 1, the living world, life. What is living? In the context of to define life, actually we need to know the characteristics of living beings. Okay, life can be defined like unique organization of molecules, expressing itself through chemical reactions, which led to different unique characteristics of living beings. Actually, it is a organization of molecules expressing itself through chemical reactions. Chemical reactions happen inside the living organisms, which led to different characteristics. Those chemical reactions exhibited outside as characteristics of living beings. That is what is life. What is living means? It is not that easy to define, but biologists defined from based on the characteristics of living beings. What are those characteristics of living beings? There are around characteristics of living beings. First one is growth. Yes, this is the main clear difference from non-living organisms. All living organisms exhibit growth. Sometimes non-living organisms also grow. Non-living objects, not organisms, like mountains, for example, mountains which are very clearly visible. But the growth is from outside. Living organisms, growth is from inside. That is the difference. Through cell division, a continuous process. This is a continuous process in living organisms. So, for example, plants grow entire life. In their entire life, plants grow, and animals grow to certain extent, and they stop growing. But later, cell division is useful for repairing. For example, if something happens to the animal, then, and the second characteristic is reproduction. Reproduction is the second characteristic, means the fusion of male and female gametes. Formation of zygote. That is the main activity in the living organisms. One is growth and second one is reproduction. And this zygote results in the formation of progeny, which are similar to parents. Progeny formation. This is one of the most main important characteristic in living organisms. And the third one is metabolism. Metabolism means it is made up of chemicals. All living organisms are made up of chemicals. The process of constant changes is called metabolism. These chemicals leads to a constant change. That's called metabolism. The chemicals are constantly undergoing some change inside the body of living organisms. This process is called metabolism. And the fourth one is sensitivity. All living organisms are sensitive to different kinds of stimuli. For example, plants grow towards sunlight. Two words are in the direction of sunlight. Animals, for example, almost all animals are go away from heat. That is what is sensitivity. Reproduction, metabolism, sensitivity. And the fifth one is cellular organization. And the fifth one is cellular organization. Means unicellular and multicellular. Unicellular, multicellular organization. Means living organisms, either they are unicellular or multicellular organization exists. And other activities like respiration, other characteristics are respiration. And seventh one is evolution. And the eighth one is homeostasis. Like this, these are the fundamental characteristics of living beings. See, if you see this thing, one is growth, second one is reproduction, third one is metabolism, fourth one is sensitivity, and the fifth one is cellular organization, sixth one is respiration, seventh one is evolution, and eighth one is homeostasis. Try to remember, if an object shows these characteristics, that is called as living object or living organism.